LHS in the reactants and RHS in the products. Then check which atoms are present, like carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Right? Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Similarly for RHS also, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Then count number of atoms of each. How many atoms are there for carbon? See, 3. That means 3 carbon atoms are there. So right here, 3. And then you have 8 hydrogen atoms and 2 oxygen atoms on LHS. Now check for on RHS. On RHS you have 1 carbon atom, 2 hydrogen atom, and oxygen here 2 and here 1. That is total 3 oxygen atom. Now on LHS you have 3 carbon, on RHS you have 1 carbon. So this carbon must be 3. So to make this carbon 3, simply multiply with 3. If you multiply with 3, then this 3 is multiplied to C as well as with this oxygen. So now the new carbon number will be 3 and new oxygen number will be 3 to the 6. Now check for hydrogen. On LHS you have 8 hydrogen, on RHS you have only 2 hydrogen. How to make these 2 hydrogen into 8? Multiply this with 4. 4 2s are 8. That means the new hydrogen is 8 now. But at the same time, the number of oxygen changed to 4. That means already you have 6 here and then 4. That means total 10. Now compare. Carbon you have 3 on LHS, 3 on RHS balanced. Hydrogen you have 8 on LHS, 8 on RHS balanced. But oxygen you have 2 on LHS, 10 on RHS. So simply multiply with 5, 5 2s are 10. Thus you check here, 3, 8, 10, 3, 8, 10. So your equation balance, one more equation. Write the equation first and then write LHS, RHS. LHS the atoms. You have iron atom, you have oxygen atom and you have aluminium. Similarly on RHS you have iron, you have oxygen, you have aluminium. Now check number of atoms of each. For iron you have 2 on LHS, for oxygen you can see 3 you have, aluminium 1. Iron you have 1, oxygen you have O3 means 3 here, aluminium Al2, 2. Let us balance it. So here only 1 iron is there, so multiply with 2, so this iron will become 2. Now oxygen is already balanced here, 3 and 3. Aluminium on LHS you have 1, on RHS you have 2. That means here on LHS you have to multiply with 2. If you multiply with 2, it will become 2 aluminium. Thus, this is your balanced. Balance one more equation. Write LHS, RHS. On LHS you have sodium and then you have oxygen, you have hydrogen. Hydrogen already we have written here. No, sulfur, oxygen already we have written here. The same element present on the right hand side, Na, O, H and S. Now number of atoms of sodium, 1 we have, oxygen 1 here and 4 here, 5, hydrogen 1 here and 2 here, 3, sulfur 1. Sodium we have only 2, oxygen 4 here and 1 here, 5, hydrogen we have 2, sulfur we have 1. Now let us balance. On LHS you have 1 sodium here, on RHS 2, so we have to multiply with 2 so that they should balance. So I am writing 2 here, so 2 Na, but number of oxygen changed now. So here 2 oxygen and here 4, so total number of oxygen will be 6, and hydrogen 2 and 2, 4. Now check for another element, oxygen. Here 6, here 5. If you work for oxygen, it look very complicated, because if you write any number here or here for oxygen, it will become very complicated. So in this case, we will check this at the end. Now check for hydrogen. Here we have 4 hydrogen, here we have 2 hydrogen. So we should get 2 more hydrogen. So if you write 2 here, then the number of hydrogen will become 4. 2 and 2. 2 2s are 4. But the number of oxygen will also change. So here 2 oxygen and here 4 oxygen. That means 6 oxygen. Now you can check 2, 6, 4, 1. 2, 6, 4, 1. Thus the equation is balanced. Let us balance one more equation. Write LHS, RHS, potassium
and then chlorine and then oxygen, same elements. Number of potassium on LH is 1 and chlorine is also 1, oxygen 3. Here potassium RH is 1, chlorine 1, oxygen 2. Potassium and chlorine are balanced. Now check with oxygen. Here 3, here 2. If you write 2 here, it will become 4, but it will be unbalanced. And if I write 2 here, then that will be helpful. If I write 2 here, then it will become 2 3s are 6. And I have to write 3 here. So that 3 2s are 6. But the number of chlorine and oxygen we have to check again. So chlorine now became 2. And potassium became 2. Here we have chlorine that is unbalanced, then multiply with 2. So you will be getting 2 potassium as well as 2 chlorine. 2, 2, 6, 2, 2, 6. That means the equation is balanced.